Spectrum obviously deals with frequency, so how do you bring in the frequency concept for a stochastic process? So the whole point, as I'm going to show you, is that if there is some sort of stationarity, even weak stationarity, then we can bring in that concept as we would do for deterministic signals. So let me just review quickly for a deterministic signal FFT. So this is a time signal. Anyway, in this case, the transform is defined as f of t e raised to minus j omega t dt. So this is a complex function. And one interesting property is that if you plot the absolute value squared of the transform, this obeys the Parseval of the equality, that is the energy of the signal, which is traditionally, we know it's the area under the given function ft. So this is the energy, but we can also show this to be equal to the area under the frequency transform absolute value squared. So this expression gives the this relation gives us Parseval's identity. So energy, either you can express it in time using the time function or the frequency function. So as I said, if the for the way this is described, most of the energy is here, so we could call this to be a bandpass signal, etc. So this is for deterministic signal. And now the question is, how do you define it for a stochastic process? So let me sort of start copying this from the deterministic place. And for each realization, remember, for stochastic process, I have multiple realizations depending on the various realizations. So for each realization, let me begin to define a property like so what I have done is right here, I took one sample realization, I found the transform of this, but rather than doing it from the minus infinity to plus infinity, I'm going to do it over a segment here. I'm going to do it over a segment minus t to t of the relation 2t. So, and therefore I'm also scaling this, which is the same as so I do the transform, then right here, and what I'm interested in is the absolute value to it. So I take absolute value to it. But unlike the deterministic case, I'm also going to divide this by. So this is, from here you can see this is the concept of energy being developed here. But for a stochastic process, because it goes on forever, more than that, that energy, what makes sense is something like the power. So I'm going to do all this operation here. I'm going to take the absolute value squared, then I'm also going to divide it over the duration. Minus capital P is for power, and this T is just to remain that we took it over a small segment minus T to T, and then we will push T out, capital T out, to cover the whole thing here. So that way we can cover the entire stochastic process. So sort of copying the concept from here. And of course this is for each realization, because this is the sort of a generalized mean of a random variable, so that's going to be another random variable. Square is another random variable. So what will make sense is to talk about the expected value of this expression. Expected value of this. So first let me start expanding this. So remember, once again, to do the Fourier transform based on a small or short segment, a symmetric segment minus t to t, and then square it, then take the expected value. So that's like mean square energy. Then you divide by the duration, so you get mean square power. So this quantity is not stochastic because this is an average quantity of the power. So everybody is clear? This is not energy. A finite energy over a finite duration divided by time. It may blow up, we will see, or it may be a finite quantity. So this is going to be 1 over 2t, expected value of 2, 1 integral is minus t to t. X of t e raised to minus j omega. So 1 over 2t, expected value of, you have two integrals, minus t to t, x of t1, e raised to minus j omega t1 dt1, another integral, minus t to t, x of t2, e raised to minus j omega t2 dt2. But this second integral is star. So that star is going to appear. The commerce conjugate is going to appear here and this will become plus. So let me put these two integrals together and take the expected value inside because this is a finite sum. And so I have here 1 over 2t, expected value of xt1, x star t2, e to the power minus j omega t1 minus t2 dt1 dt2. So of course this is the autocorrelation function of t1 of the process. So you can see the autocorrelation function comes in. So remember, this is sort of the average power by getting motivated by the deterministic signal. So this is 1 over 2t minus t to t minus t to t rxx. Alright, so you can see here, here already we have t1 minus t2, the difference of time indices. Whereas here in general, it's going to be, if the process has no stationarity, then this is going to be t1 comma t2. So let's consider the, and then it involves of course the two, so if there is no stationarity, you can go in this manner. But if you want to impose the weakest form of stationarity, which is the Whiteson stationary, then this will become t1 minus t2. So let's assume that x of t is Whiteson stationary. That's what I'm going to assume. Otherwise, you stick with this definition. That as well. So then this will become t1 minus t1 minus t2 e raised to minus j omega t1 minus t2 dt1 dt2. So t1 minus t2 is, so look at here, this integration, there's only one variable, tau, because both the places it appears as tau. So this becomes now 1 over 2t minus t to t minus t to t rxx tau e to the power minus j omega tau d dt1 dt. So the trouble is, or the problem is, there is only a tau is of course t1 minus t2, but the integration need to be done over, so let's see, over the two variables. Let's see whether how this. So you can say before I proceed, I should be able to convert this into one variable tau. So I should be able to write this as 1 over 2t for the rxx. So let's see. So I'm going to draw this line t1 minus t2 equal to tau. So this is xy. How will the x minus y equal to something? How will the line be? That line will be this way. So this is T1 minus T2 equal to tau. So let's mark the point. Or let me draw a proper way. Anyway, but proper way. So this is T1, this is T2, this is the line T1 minus T2 equal to tau. So let's mark the point. Look here, when T2 is 0, T1 is? So where is that point? Here, right? This is tau. And what is this point, anybody? I'm drawing this. T1 goes from minus T to T, so this is minus T. This is plus t, this is minus t, this is plus t. So if this is tau, this is t, how much is this distance? Anyone? This is tau minus t, this is a 45 degrees line, so this, how much is this? Tau minus t, right? So how much is this then? This whole thing is? This is t, right? So this is t. T minus tau minus t. T minus tau minus t. 2t minus tau. Why can't you get this? Minus, minus, minus plus t. So now, look at here. But now, I'm going to make a change in dt1, dt2. If you change any T1 or T2, tau is going to change. So I'm going to make a small change in tau. So let's say this is T1 minus T2 equal to tau plus delta tau. So what we need to see, so look at the argument. I just need to integrate over this square. One way I can integrate, if I integrate on tau, I'm going to integrate over this region, because over this region, T1 minus T2 is a constant. It's only a delta tau. So if I can find out this marked area, then I can just shift this tau. So first of all, let's see the limits on the tau. What will be the limits on tau? T1 can take minus T2 and this can take plus T2. Then this will be, what will be the lower limit, what will be the upper limit? Minus 2T is one case and the upper case. It's clear, right? Because you can take this to be minus T and this to be plus T. Minus T, minus T. I hope it is clear to you, tau goes from minus 2t to t. So what will be this line, anyone? This will be t1 minus t2 equal to? Very good, right? And this line will be? So that will be 2t. So you see, tau moves here, it will cover this ring here. So, look at here, to find this area, let me call this area to be delta A. Delta A is, look at here, at least listen to the argument. Area of this big triangle minus the area of this triangle. So this is corresponding to, I guess, minus. So what is the area of this triangle? We know these two sides. This side is 2t minus tau. So what's the area of this triangle? I know this side, I know this side. It's a right angle triangle. So the first area is half. 2t minus tau, the whole squared, okay. Minus the second. What's the difference between you just have to replace tau by tau minus delta tau or plus delta tau, depending on which way it goes. So what will be the area? Second triangle, the smaller triangle. Replace tau by tau minus delta tau. So this is half 2t minus tau plus or minus delta tau. Okay. So minus half 2t minus tau. Let me write it this way. So look, expand this. You can see this term will cancel with this, because this is like a plus b or either way is fine. Yeah, this is a, this is a, this is b. So a minus b the whole squared is a squared. The a squared and a squared would cancel. Then you have 2ab, which is 2t minus tau multiplied by half multiplied by delta tau. Then you have delta tau squared. This I am going to ignore because the usual Newton argument, differential argument, the differential is so small on the higher order powers. So bottom line is, what is the area of this trapezium? Anybody? Just this. So look here, this dt1 by dt2, I can replace it by 2t minus tau or delta tau. I put an absolute value because even if I take it on the other side, the same argument. Plus or minus. Remember, somewhere here I could do this as like this. Then I don't need, if I put a plus sign, then I don't need this. So let me write down all this. Tau here is to minus j omega tau. Then I have 2t minus tau. Instead of delta tau, I am going to put d tau. So look here, I'm going to take this 2t and put it below this, so that this expression now becomes minus 2t to 2t rxx tau e raised to minus j omega tau 1 minus tau over 2t d tau. Alright, so we are almost done. So this quantity, let me have, before I proceed further, is this quantity, what is one property you see? Remember, there is a j here. So anything multiplied by a complex number in general is a complex number. But do you see that this quantity is actually real and positive? Anybody? This integral is actually real and positive. Yes or no? Look at where we started with. This is a complex quantity and we squared it blindly. So it's going to be a positive number. So there is no question, this number is always, this is always a positive function. Irrespective of this j, that's what we need. Now let me do the other stuff. Remember, I did this all because I didn't want to consider minus infinity the first infinity to start with. So I'm going to push, I'm going to consider the entire process. That means all I have to do is, at this point, I'm going to take the limiting case. To push this to limit t goes to infinity. So this is going to be limit t goes to infinity. So if I push this, then this is going to look like minus infinity to, look at here, minus infinity to plus infinity rxx tau e raised to minus j omega tau. Look at here, this is 1, t goes to infinity, t is here, so this term vanishes. And this is anyway triangular function, non-negative function. That becomes more and more like just one function. 1 minus this, so that vanishes. Then d tau. Of course, this is the Fourier transform of the autocorrelation function. And this function is always positive. Why is this true? I just explained to you. Because we squared it and started. So this is Wiener-Kinchin theorem. The Fourier transform of an autocorrelation function is, first of all, is always non-negative. And so let me denote this function by here. So that's now on our property, so it may not be obvious by looking at our autocorrelation function, why it's transformed is. Also, what I have shown is if you take the Fourier transform of an autocorrelation function, obviously I'm talking about white sensation. The first property is that it is positive. For many notations, I'm going to denote it like this, this limiting case. So this expression, the limit of this, I'm going to call it SXX only. S is for power spectrum. Why is this power spectrum? So let me show you this. So immediately we get the inverse transform. If you take the inverse transform, we get from the Fourier transform discussion, the inverse transform relation is this with a plus sign here. Remember, this integration is with respect to tau, this integration is with respect to omega. So you can get the autocorrelation function this way. And from here you get, if you put tau equal to 0, what do you get? Anybody? So this is the question. If you put tau equal to 0, what do you get? The integral to 0. Huh? Integral from? Just the area under this function. So I know that this, look at here, I know this function is positive, SXX omega. And the second property is this one. What does the area sum up to? Area under the function is? Huh? What is this quantity? You just multiply this. Hello? Expected value? Right. So we also get expected value of x squared t, which is the total power, is distributed in the frequency domain by this function. So this must be the power spectral density, because the total power is the area under this function. So the total power is this, which is going to be minus infinity to plus infinity SXX omega b. So you see, so this is the Wiener-Kinschen theorem. The power spectral density is given by the Fourier transform of autocorrelation function. So the two things have been proved. First of all, it's a non-negative density function. The second property is that this one. The total power is given by the area under this function. So if the area is maximum here, I would assume that whatever is happening in the frequency domain, most of the action is here. So you can say that whatever is this phenomenon, the bandwidth is in this domain. So to get the bandwidth, you need to find out the autocorrelation function. Then you need to take the Fourier transform in the classic way. You can also, so it goes both ways. If you have a power spectrum, what does it mean? Look at here. If you have a power spectrum, if I do the inverse transform, what do you get? Of some process. So if you, by hand, if I draw a power spectrum like this, this is actually the power spectrum. I can find a stochastic process corresponding to this. So what will be the operation? Anyone? How will I find a stochastic process? First of all, I can find the autocorrelation function. Then we need to have figure out the ways how to generate a process with that corresponding autocorrelation function. And Tumor, I also showed you earlier that autocorrelation function has non-negative definite properties. So let me derive it from the power spectrum. So one of the major results is what I just said. For a wide substation of resources, the autocorrelation function and the transform of the autocorrelation function gives you the power spectrum. So if x of t is wide substationary, then all xx tau and its power spectrum, Fourier transform power spectrum, gives you the power spectrum, which is non-negative. So it will be a function like this. I hope you appreciate that. When I take the voting transform, I'm not taking the absolute value like in the deterministic case. That was done a while ago. Here I'm just taking the voting transform. But still, it turned out to be a positive thing. So you have. You have RxX tau is what is it? SxX omega e to the power plus j omega tau d omega. This is inverse relation. It's a 1 over 2 pi. And then it's 1 over 2 pi. Square root of 2 pi is put here, square root is put on the other side. So this also means, look at here. RxxTi minus Tj is this expression. So I just replace the tau by Tj minus Tj. Now, anybody remembers positive definiteness? How do you check the whether this function is positive definite or not? What was the expression? How you check this? This is a two variable function. So you create a matrix from Rij A star A. So this is going to be double summation AI AJ star, then what? In our case, it is Whiteson special. It's a comma tj. But we want to show that this is positive. We want to show that's what we mean by positive. So let me give you a different proof. This is for any number of any size, I equal to 1, 2, 3. So let me substitute this expression here. RxxTi minus tj is here. So this is going to be 1 over 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity. So double summation AI AJ star, then I have e raised to minus j omega TI e raised to plus j of this is plus n. This is plus. I don't know whether you see this, but I can see that I can write the inside mess like this. Look here, A here is this, and the other term is exactly complex conjugate of that. So I can write it as the square of this function. But look here, this is positive, the power spectrum is positive, so the whole thing will be positive. We just prove that the another way autocorrelation function is positive. Please go home and redo all these things by hand. So this will open up, and if I give you a picture like this, is this an autocorrelation function? So the answer is, now you have a very simple answer. If a function is autocorrelation, how will it be? The power spectrum will have what property? You just conclude it. If an autocorrelation is, if this is a valid autocorrelation, power spectrum will be positive. So is this an autocorrelation function? My question is, yes or no? Can this be an autocorrelation function? Why not? Oh, so that's the answer. Look at here. If this was an autocorrelation function, its Fourier transform will be what? Sinc. Sinc was positive and negative. So it's not a positive function. So you don't need to do anything. So now you can take all sorts of examples. Can this be an autocorrelation function? Is this an autocorrelation function? Why?
X squared.
So the transform of this is sinc squared So always it's transforming simply to so positive function. So power spectrum is for. How about this? If I flip it. So this also looks like a triangle. Can this be an autocorrelation function? What is the first property of an autocorrelation function? Where is its maximum value? So that cannot be an autocorrelation. So sometimes I give a few pictures like this just to see your understanding. Autocorrelation function is. So draw some pictures and see what is an autocorrelation function, what is not autocorrelation function. So it is. So again, the function is autocorrelation function. It's Fourier transform. You don't have to call it spectrum. Fourier transform is non-negative. So you can use this as a test almost. But of course, if the function is not Poisson stationary, you cannot do this. So then, like a Wiener process or Poisson process, then you have to use to figure out this somehow, some other way. So it's not like every problem can be solved by one method. With multiple ways of looking at the same thing. Something works better in one case, something somewhere else, etc.